Good evening, friends. And today we are honored to have AIMS and PGI topper Dr. Vishnu. And he was our test and discussion student. And we are very proud of Vishnu. And heartiest congratulations to you for your such a good rank in PGI exam. He was PGI 27 and he was AIMS 190 rank. And it was really a very heartwarming result. And we are all wishing you a very good future ahead. And now we want to know from you, because everybody knows you are happy, right? So I'm not going to ask those questions. So I want to ask this thing, how you have prepared for this exam? Means what was the time when you started and what was the problem you have came across while you are doing preparation for this exam?
First, the initial problem was obviously not a good base in the MBBS years. To be honest, I was not into so much of the subject, and also I was into a bit of UPSC and maybe going into that. But although at the end of internship, I decided that yeah, I'll be here and I'll be doing my PG. And I gave the exam at the end of my internship. I got around 13,000 rank. So for those who might not be at a very good stage now, I just want to say that you can come back from anywhere to anywhere. And even after internship, it's not been a continuous 15-month study. There have been a lot of lapses, especially in the first five, six months, where I had to decide what to study and accumulate my sources and everything. So essentially, maybe it was 12 months 10-11 months of rigorous study, and I think you can come from well behind to the top 50 or a top 20 rank. Always my main motto was to keep things simple and concise, because I always felt, and many might feel, that my memory was bad. So I always wanted to keep things concise, always made notes and kept those notes from individual classes and everywhere, and kept revising them 4-5 times. The number of revision might be a vague indicator, because for some it might be each reading would be a bit thorough, for some it would be a rapid read. So number of revisions is a bit vague, but keep your sources concise and keep revising them.
Okay, Dr. Vishnu, actually I want to ask you one thing, which actually every student will be wishing to from you, because right now your status is like you are a topper, right? You are a topper of PGI exam and AIMS exam. So, but as you said, you got 13,000 rank while doing internship. So what was your reaction that time? Because many of your colleagues would have got very good rank and your rank was not up to the mark. Because from that point of life, and coming up to this stage, definitely you would have gone with so much of trauma in your mind. So how you used to console yourself? Means, okay, I can do it, or I should go for it. Means, what was your deeper motivation?
To be very honest, I never had that kind of very low confidence. I always had that confidence, maybe because I did pretty well in my UG exams. But I always had this lack of confidence, because I never was good in biology. So it was a mix kind of mindset, but obviously 13,000 kind of shook me, because I never had this kind of rank. But obviously it's a good experience always to have a low in your life. So but then I obviously thought ki abhi utna nahi padha hai, abhi padhenge. So then I improved in May, and that's how I did till November. From May to November I was very thorough. So at the end of the day, I feel ki you have to have one particular block of time, 6-8 months, whenever. Don't keep it like 16 months mein agar thoda pad liya to nahi hoga, kyunki bhul jaoge 16 months mein. Around 6-8 months ideally before NEET, or if you're focusing only AIMS, ideally before May. So keep that block and go all out, matlab leave everything else. Maybe obviously it depends, keep if you're really interested in some hobby, keep the free time for that. But obviously keep them to minimal, and that block of time you have to give your whatever 100% or whatever it is.
So Vishnu, actually I want to ask you, you said ki you were very concise. And I want to know that what way you were very concise means what was your strategy when you started from, you said you were shook by the result and then you decided you will go for it, you will go for the all out. So you started, you were telling me you are minimizing your things or you are concising your thing. So what was your strategy means what subject did you focus, or the basic subjects were very important for cracking such exams with good rank, or final year subjects are, actually all things are important. What I want to say that everything is important, but there is something which will be building the base. So what were the baselines, what were the building base subjects for you?
First of all, there is an issue with most of the guidebooks in this market. The thing is that in the guidebooks there are a lot of additional points which may be important for, I mean, they are the fringe topics, they may not be very important, and also in some topics there are some lines written which may be needed to be skipped. So I was, personally I'm a bit bad at understanding this is the most important and gradation of those topics. So I never wanted to go into that risk, and I kept myself to notes, because notes, the faculty already have filtered the guidebooks and they've given us. So that was the strategy behind notes, keeping notes higher than guidebooks. Or there would be people who know and they feel more comfortable with guidebooks. They might feel that we at least have that cushion ki we are covering everything, so something we'll get. If that is a strategy, that was fine. I've seen people doing that really, really well. But yeah, that was the reason behind this. And subjects, I think as far as AMC is concerned, initially, maybe 2-3 sessions back, it was most of first, second year. But now they have gone very balanced. I mean, there is no particular, especially in AIMS, because in other, maybe NEET or PGI, you know the pattern, you know the distribution, this subject this much. But in AIMS, this time there were 22-23 obligatory questions, which are usually 15 or 14. And NAT questions were 10 or something, which are usually 18-19. So the most important thing for AIMS is to keep it balanced. All the subjects should be done well, and for PGI and everything, you know the distribution. I think immunology, biochemistry, genetics are those high yielding classes.
Okay, so I, Vishnu, I want to ask few things for my student. Means I will categorize two things. We will discuss about what you did for AIMS and how you improved in PGI, because his rank was 190 in AIMS, and after 7 days his PGI exam was there. And then definitely, by seeing his friends, they have got, because his colleagues have got very good rank in AIMS exam. So definitely his mindset will be going some kind of turbulence. But how he has managed these 7 days? Because within 7 days people, they say that within 7 days you cannot create miracle. But it is not like 7 days. You know? It is something which your mind actually knows. Ki, this is your strength. So first we will talk about AIMS, right? Ki, for AIMS, when you wrote, so you said you made notes, right? So I want to ask all, because for all students, sometimes they feel only notes are enough, which they are jotting down from the lectures, right? So what do you feel? Is it really enough? According to your perspective, is it really enough that notes, or you should read some then and there, some MCQs and some important topics you are coming across via grand test or via some discussion, then you should read those topics and you add on into your notes?
Sir, first of all, for AIMS exam, it was a weird kind of result, because I had a 229 rank in November, and again I almost gave at least three and a half months of good study. But it was weird, maybe because I had left obs gyne in the end, I couldn't revise, so that affected me. The other point was that notes is the base, but don't think that this is only the base and we need to add too much into it. Grand test, there's no doubt that is the I'd suggest every week, if not 2 weeks, not in the initial days, but like last 3-4 months, not even last 1 month, last 3-4 months every week you give it, because, and you give only grand test, subject wise tests in the initial days, but grand test all the time, because that is how you will know what other subjects, yeah, how
what
other
are your weaker areas, yeah, and you can modify that thing.
And yeah, suppose we are studying one subject and we have completed the 19th one some 3 months back, so yeah, you'll know how much we remember.
So for AIMS, how many questions you attempted?
I attempted 192.
192, and what was your approximate? How much you would have got in aims?
We actually sat down and calculated, but according to our calculations, I was getting around 100 marks, but I think it would be much lower than that, maybe 95 or something. Yeah, my actual mark, because like we have an idea of the cutoff, so mine would be 95 marks.
Okay. So after AIIMS, because after AIIMS your exam was PGI.
Yeah.
So how did you go for PGI exam? Means what was your strategy for PGI exam?
I was actually giving the PGI exam for the first time this time.
Okay.
I always focused on AIIMS, but this time first of all I didn't know ki this x, A by X minus B by Y.
That's marking.
Yeah, marking scheme. So first of all I saw Mukh Mohit sir's PGI video on YouTube. That how to attempt the paper and how many to attempt, at what percentage if you're sure you need to attempt. And then I gave one paper some last 2 years back. I planned to do all six papers, previous six, but first of all I gave the last 2 years wala paper, and I saw that it's better to mark only if you're like much more than 50%, 75-80% sure.
Uh-huh.
No, unlike AIIMS where one eliminated then you
can go back. Yeah.
But here I think you have to be pretty sure to actually mark it, and that's how I think strategy helped me a lot in getting a good rank in PGI, because it's not like I read too much in that 1 week in between.
Yeah.
I was actually just checking my AIIMS paper and everything, and just give one or two papers PGI. So I think strategy helped me.
In PGI, how many options you have attempted out of 1250 approximately? Did you check?
Actually, I didn't check, sir. But I was checking ki per question. Like I just saw a block of 20, and I was checking. I think I was attempting 2 to 3 per 5. Per question, 2 to 3 options I was checking.
Okay.
So that would be around 500.
500 around. So that's what I wanted to say, students also. Ki if you are If you are willing for a good rank in AIIMS exam, you should go for 190 plus minus 5, and PGI exam is also like 500, 550. Exactly. This number of options should be attempted. So Vishnu, actually I want to ask you one basic thing, because most of the students, they succumbed in last 1 month. Right? What you did in last 1 month and what you did in last 7 days, what was your strategy?
In May 2017, that was the time when I was giving my almost first so sincere and like serious attempt. That was there was 1 month, the April month or the March month, when like I just lost track. Matlab aise lag raha tha ki nahi hoga ab, and obviously hua bhi nahi, but that's not a good thing. Nahi bhi hoga to padhte rehna hai, matlab
you should not give up actually.
Yeah, yeah. That was actually the point when I joined this institute. When like I wasn't able to focus, and then I took a TND, and I think in that aspect TND is a very good thing. It keeps your track till the end, and that's it depends. One thing to do to prevent this last 1 month fiasco, it's very very common. It happens to all at least once, or at least it affects to certain extent, is to be mentally prepared from before. That last 1 month, this thing will happen. Things will get left out, you will have to tone down on your amounts, do something, but being mentally prepared will help a lot.
And as you said, you joined our test series, right? So our test and discussion. So which faculty had influenced you? Means whose teaching abilities has influenced you and helped you a lot in PGI exam and AIIMS exam?
Sir, I was surprised to see the list of the faculty when I first saw the institute, because they were really good, I was genuinely surprised, can't say anything more than that so many good faculty are there at one place. That's the reason I joined. Mukh Mohit sir's video, obviously, specifically for PGI.
PGI exam, he is one of the good mentor for PGI.
Yeah, that helped me a lot. Apart from that, obviously all the TND coaching classes, those help in the obviously for the knowledge.
Okay. And I want to ask you one question for my students, that what you followed for images, because images are like one of the thing which everybody is so much of scared about. So means how did you know ki this image can be your question? Means this image can be your future question, or in your AIIMS exam this kind of image will be asked. or I will follow this book or this book. So any particular book you want to recommend to students which they should follow or which will be must for their preparation?
First of all, I studied the USMLE first aid very thoroughly, because as in AIMS, everybody studies, and there were a lot of papers which were very, very based on that. So USMLE first aid, I also did UWorld of USMLE for path and medicine specifically, especially for histopath. And apart from that, I think I didn't need to go through Robbins, because I read Devesh sir's path book and there were a lot of images in that. And apart from that, I didn't feel, because those questions literally helped me a lot, the UWorld questions, radiographs and histopath questions. And yeah, for other, if you are not wanting to go through UWorld, because that is a major, that will take a major chunk of your preparation time. Yeah. So if you don't want to go through that and you're wanting, then standard textbooks are a very good thing. Just the image and the text below that, that's it. Don't go into all the text and don't get like flowed away. If you're not understanding
then you can go into the paragraph, read about that image. That is what I used to say that in my lecture also. Okay, here you see the images, go with that lines given below those images. They are important to understand, and that is how we should prepare. Yeah. So actually what I want to ask you one more question, means how you come to know that these topics are important, means what way you come to know that this topic is important, means from the TND and from solving some 10-year question paper, something you did like this?
AIMS has specific topics. It's tough to just go through the papers and like inculcate ki ye important hai. You'll have to write down again and again, do the previous papers. For the juniors coming in the next years, previous papers of AIMS are becoming more important day by day, because initially the pattern changed in November 15 or something, then the repeats drastically reduced and now they're again increasing back. I think PATH is one subject where they actually, surprisingly, they want repeat topics. I don't know why. Maybe it's because it's a vast subject, so they want to limit to specific topics. Apart from that, there are a few subjects like ANAT, a lot of repeat topics. So Rajesh Kaushal sir's class almost exclusively focuses on repeat questions. So that is very, very good. ANAT, PATH, micro, ortho, there are some more subjects where repeats are not being asked a lot. So previous papers is the...
Previous papers. So what do you say that in last 7 days, if you are aiming for AIMS exam, how many question papers, how many years question paper you should try to set a goal? A 5-year question paper or 3-year question paper in last 7 days?
That November 15, the pattern changed. From there, you will have to do it. Maybe I think 5 papers or maybe 6 now. Yeah, I think 6 papers now after this May. So those 6 papers you do. And in the last 7 days, it's tough to go through all the explanations.
Yeah.
By then, you might have already gone through. So just
question, answer, and
question,
see the explanation.
Yeah, there are exact repeats. I mean, the AIMS people don't want to do it, but there are exact repeats.
And what I also felt ki by seeing these, as you said, 2015 onwards when images had been asked or increased, since then they had increased the amount of topics, actually I should say that ki topics are same, but the question is getting different. Same topics, same schwannoma, same fungal infection, same silver stain. What I am also feeling ki examiner is asking from the same topic. So what we should say to our student ki topic will be same, MCQ will be different, so you should focus on those topics, especially those who have been repeated in last 3 to 5 years.
Yeah.
Right?
I think a lot of everybody's preparation also depends on what he wants.
Yeah.
Maybe if someone wants a top 5 rank, he can go a bit beyond just the repeat topics, because then the repeat topics will be done by a lot of people.
Yeah, so then he has to go extra mile. Yeah, something extra you have to give.
Yeah, but not everybody, even I never actually aimed for top 10. So it's not like that. If somebody wants to focus on NEET along with AIMS, then maybe he can just do the repeat topics repeatedly for AIMS, and obviously his NEET preparation will come to the fore, which I think is usually the common scene with everybody. So I think sticking to repeat topics specifically for AIMS is good.
And Vishnu, I want to ask you one more thing. Did you find revision plays a very crucial role in cracking these exams?
Yes, sir. Unless you have read you have really brilliantly read in your MBBS, it's not possible to do it without revision. There are some people who have just read one and a half time in their internship and then got it even top 10, top 20, right? But that is because they have done so many revisions in their MBBS that it might be their 12th revision. So everybody reads the same amount of hours. Even the 10th ranker will read the same amount of hours, if not a bit less, because their hours are clumped. Even the 10th ranker who gets in first attempt and the 10th ranker who gets in fifth attempt approximately reads the same number of hours. Although because their hours are clumped, so they get a more advantage. So everybody revises, and that is the main thing. There's nothing without revision.
Okay, actually, to my all students, what I want to say that Dr. Vishnu has not a very ordinary kind of life. So he has his turbulence. He has seen so much of darkness in his life. But in these time, he has kept going on. So Vishnu, actually, in the last, I want to ask you some motivation which you want to give to my students. What advice you want to give, what motivation you will give to them so that they can also stick to those things, because many of them, they have not selected in this aims, but definitely they will be targeting next aims exam or All India exam, BJ exam. So what is your just one message, maybe some 5 minutes or 2 minutes, but that should motivate them and that should help them to remember your words for their preparation.
Sir, first of all, the first and foremost thing is you have to believe that you can do it. And it's a big joke if you think that you can't do it, because this exam is nowhere related to something like mathematical aptitude or something. This is related to repeated revision, correlating things, which again comes from repeated revision. So everything in this exam, everybody can do. I mean, anyone who knows English and can understand things can do it, and that's the foremost thing. Apart from that, there is no substitute to hard work. It's not like you go to this coaching or that coaching and it will happen by itself. You have to work hard, you have to sit in your room, open the book and study, and that's the main thing. I think hard work beats everything in this exam.
So, a very very thanks to Dr. Vishnu. So, the last line what he said, that it doesn't depend on anything, it's you only, and you have to give your 100% best effort, and remember, you can do it. Just that belief will make you going, and you just stick to it. So don't see around your world what is happening. Just you focus on yourself, success will come you, and only one thing which is constant in this world, that is the hard work, which will bring the success, right?
Sir, lastly, I also want to thank the Prime Institute, because I joined this institute at a weird time when I kind of lost track in the last 1 month, because I had just started and the exam had come. So it helped me in a really tough time.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Vishnu. Thank you so much, Vishnu. And we team Prime, we are wishing you a very great future ahead, and we will be always with you. Even when you are doing your post graduation, we will be always there to help you. And thank you so much, Vishnu. And wishing you very, very good wishes, many, many more success in your life. Thanks. Thank you.